Indian people, this is God's gift. Thank you, Adam. Yakove, Kabapnikioa, Mele, Bad. Yako, Missam Quatak, Mr. Halal. Will a tough way here, Quahatak, my Yakne, Arnoa, Hatted. Make a matanote, and I'm not a guy, you know me. Ayan ito ahiyel eh, mas yak na ito safa panghulaya lapakasik maatay tafa matkiya yomig matis na atik maasiyan o kiya to biye ka fulla yomig matanoti lapang ahiyel eh nana ay tiba nukfihin eh ay tiba fiyakat Nana his day as a duet, won't ask a pulita. I can lay over, I can know a hostia, I see a fair kid. How can it come to my heart to come out if I hear him ask you? You all make a matter note. He was not die at the come out for lama. I'm a hair. Nana is dying to Napa, yes, yeah, Arthur of the kid. Is happy, happy, la happy, yeah. Harnit, some co has taken my heart, take my eye, him, but let us hear the heart, take my eye, appeal at it. Now your father is in it, is happy, not to go, no. I need your honesty. Nana is hurt, Leo, he's missing his heart. Jo ni alma ta noti na na kila si ho futta ho siya si kaya na jo mi ho ka yamma futta miyo mahatag mat ikamaya pesa kaya na yamma mi kulla si amen
nito sabers lesman Calvin isa mo makadomite. At this time, I would like to say something here that I have said in the past, and I will continue to say it. I am not against anybody that is holding dances or is doing something about Indian culture. And I'd rather see it go on. I don't care who teaches it. I appreciate it. I like it. And I hope that this will continue on and on. And right now, I don't think that you give Mr. Taylor a good hand in the kids that he's teaching. So let's give him another big hand, please.
We're discussing right here on what dances, or what dance we're going to start first. This is a dance. It's a form of a social dance. The song is sung with the chanting. After about 3 chants or 2 chants, we break in and dance. They almost say it's two-step if you watch the feet movement. The dance itself, the feet movement, it should be done in unison. Every dancer, the steps should be done all at once. This is when you see these dances. This is Choctaw's way of dancing. It should be done this way when everybody with this step, every move with their feet should be moved at the same time. This is when the dance is real good. In the song, if there is a meaning, I don't know. I'll have to give you that answer on the song. But we do at times put in a few words, which is in different dancing, we have a different type of song, that there is a Choctaw word put in there where you can't understand it if you're a Choctaw. This one, for instance, the tick dance, the movement should not be fast, slow, and most of these dances we have, it dance very slow. This way, the arms are close together, and just tight as can be, so that the movement of the feet can be together, unison. In unison, rather. If you watch the feet movement, you can see what I mean. It should be that way with all the dancers. The little woman with the glasses on is a Chickasaw, and you see myself, and right next to me is another Chickasaw. This is a Choctaw Chickasaw heritage that are dancing. Now we're going into another tick dance here, but the man usually starts these dances off. All these dances, the man starts it off and starts this tick dance, and then the women join in, and this way it's always danced. The men start off, and the women joined in the singing. In most tribes, you see, where the women don't sing, but the Choctaws, the women always sing it. This is another picture. Seems awful pretty, so we put them on all kids, and especially the men they wear them. Women wear them too, a long time ago. We have several old pictures that show women wearing them. They would all be made into this cloth, and it's sewed into a belt. And it's beadwork, but the design is there's only about 4 designs that you use, we can use, really, so that's why you don't see so many designs, different designs on these trophies. We sing sometimes. You can, if you listen it for a while, you can wake up next morning, you can still hear. Let's see now, if you notice, a few minutes ago I was talking to the leader there, right there, Adam Benson. He sings these old songs. These old songs, some of these songs you can hear, as I said before. But this is what I wanted to bring out to show you, that our song, you can, as I say, if you listen at it for a little while, you can be able to hear it next morning. Like an instinct. You know when to come in and sing, and what you know what to say when you join in. Just like these little kids dancing here, they going right in and watch. And this is the way I learned it. And of course, this is best teaching principle here, practical application. It's the best teacher. So That's just why these new kids dance with us, Dave. Learn it, and they can carry on years later. Adam Sampson, this gentleman standing not there, is 70 years old. He's a full-blood Choctaw. This dance is also a trick dance, but then I say it's different in different forms. Now, this dance is particularly called Feeling Partner. In Choctaw, we call it the Timo Levy. It sort of self-explanatory, but this dance could not be danced. I mean, this dance long ago was not danced by the married personnel or the kinfolk, relatives, been danced together. And it's just danced by the unmarried couple, the boy and his girlfriend were the only one that danced it. And while they were dancing, they'd holler and go get another girl from the other boy's girl. So that's the reason it's called Feeling Partner. You will see when we start. We dance it, but you don't start and they come up, one of them hollers and go get a girl. That's just there. Sometimes they fight over girls. What I mean fight over girls is that one dancer will go get one girl and at the same time another gentleman can come and get the same girl. That's what I mean. They do this. I hope they little kids doing this. Hey, that's just what I mean. They can take one other girl away from the other one. That's why it is called Feeling Partner. But the dance is still a kick dance. But the name is different. Now, this is why I'm telling them little children to go ahead and do it. I want them to do it because they know how.
Yeah. Our next, it's not a dance. This song is about what, it's a memorial song, in other words. We're going to sing it. This song was sung when the Choctaw family, one of the family died. The mourning went on for a period of 1 year. The husband or the wife, which one was surviving, could not venture out into the world or could not see the unmarried woman, if in case she was, in case he was a man, and vice versa with the woman. Now, at the end of 1 year, this song was sung. It's more of a religious deal, ceremony. And we had a pleasure of doing this because we've been picking up old songs as long as Adam can remember them. And the song is called Palata, which means it is a lost a woman or something, a translation that. But you can always come down to as a memorial song because this song was sung when the mourning of the person was over in 1 year's time. Now, this is an old tradition. So I hope that we can sing it good for you. Now, I wish all the committee members to come in and form a circle. We're not going to dance. We're just going to sing. Thing goes, the good event, good things are going, must have an end. And in the days that we had these dances, I used to go on sometime a week, sometime 3 days, sometime 2 days, and one. But everything have to come close. On our dancing, each night when we dance, the dances long time ago used to come to an end at by the sunrise. So it's always known that the last dance is the snake dance.
It was said a long time ago that the Choctaws did not worship, but they liked the snake. So they honored him. They honored the snake in a dance. The snakes were helpful to the Choctaws, or possibly the rest of the tribes, different tribes, by eating the insects or rodents in the garden. So when the Choctaws honored this, the snakes, well, they made a dance. But then, this must have been the last thing that they honored, or might have been the last thing that they did. So in doing this, well, they made the snake dance, the last dance of these dances. So at any time when we have dances, this is always the last dance, the snake dance. The snake dance now, as you will see here, is in the same thing. Now, this here, we would be going in, the snake would be going into the coil and coming out of the coil. Thought about these snakes and everything, but the most they talk about snakes was the rattlesnake. And I believe that the design, the diamond on some of these costumes is derived from that, a diamond back rattlesnake. Now, with this dance going on here, the snake has come out of the coil and it's moving out again. Before the kids learn by doing, and this is what they're doing here, they dance. This is the way I learn. back in the 1930s. I'm going into another call. I'll be coming out of it in a minute. There are many dances the Choctaws have done. There's a berry dance, there's a turkey dance, there's a Chickasaw dance. And there's a berry dance. Now you will notice here that we're going into another call again. But whatever dances that have been handed down, we have a few. We don't have all of them. But I don't know if Mr. Johnson will be able to bring more out. We'll try. Some of these dances have been lost forever. I know that the six dogs have been lost too many. So I hope that this, what we gave you, will help in your future. Thank you.
We certainly do thank you for the honors you bestowed upon us by being here. We appreciate it very much. I know there's other people the public school system has supported us in this Indian Heritage Day, and all our other guests. We thank you very much for being here. Now, therefore, if you'll give us a few minutes in the kitchen. Thank you.
Thank you.
Amen.
Mitte, Sabers, Lisman, Calvin, Isa Momaka Domite. At this time, I would like to say something here that I have said in the past, and I will continue to say it. I am not against anybody that is holding dances or is doing something about Indian culture. And I'd rather see it go on. I don't care who teaches it. I appreciate it. I like it. People, this is God's gift. Thank you, Adam.
You're correct. I'm not sure. I am not a healer. Nana his day as a dugat, won't ask a pullet yard. I can lay over, I can know a host yard, I feel the air kit. How can it come across the Kamahat Kama if I him ask ye? You all make a matter note here. He was not die at the Kama for Lamas. I'm a Nana is dying, and the